You always got to be careful. You never know when you're going to have a run-in with something really unique and beautiful. There's a chip laid down there. And doing this is, you know, it's a lot slower, but it's fun. You're just basically slicing through this cake that has all these possibilities in it. But it is very slow. So there's that chip layer about a foot down from the surface. Nice little flakes. Percussion flakes. Pressure flaking. Okay, there's some in there. Whoopsie. I just have to look at it and see it's a chip. But you never know. Orange. That's a flake. But that color is just amazing. If you find something like that, made of that, is really beautiful. I'm going to go into a little hole here and probe, see what I can get. Kind of cool off a little bit before my visitor gets here. How easy it would be. You just come down on one. I'm kind of liking taking blocks of this stuff and just going through it faster. Since we're not trying to save the data of this spot here. We're not what we're digging through now. There's tons of this, and there's areas I've set aside completely intact for that purpose. Oh, there's some up in there. And the temptation is I want to go touch it again with the tool. Don't do that. Damn. See that? Even that tool, if that's a nice point, it's gonna suck. And it looks like it could be. Oh, yeah. Well, I can have these things repaired, which is nice. But look at the color. I think it's a chip. But the color of that thing is really nice. Oopsie. It's hard to hold the camera with my left hand. Well, let's see if I can just dig with the left hand. That's a little better. Okay. It doesn't feel as dexterous with this hand, but I did make candles with my left hand for a long time. And soon I'll probably just get another camera that'll just be attached to me that I can turn off and on. I'm getting into a lot of chips here. There's chips all over the place, but you get in these little concentrations and you find points around them or broken stuff that they're working on. Just go back to kicking, I think. The sight only gives you so many chances to crush something, even if it's a chip. At least that's the way I feel. You get three chances to crush an edge of something before you'll crush a point. Interesting about this little shovel is I can just shave with it with one hand. Oh, double touching things is so bad. That was my second chance, or maybe third. I apologize if my hand wanders a little bit here. Just barely touching something is nice. Just pull things out if I find something. Chip. Ooh, there's something over there. That might have been a root, but let's see. Yeah, sometimes the roots sound pretty hard. Ooh, that's the shovel. Okay, so let's go back to using that. Okay. Hit something and stop. Shit. Like active little pocket over there. Uncovered chip. I'll just pop that right there. Okay. And I'll get down to the layer below this. I'm not gonna ignore that. But there's these two top layers that we can dig here. Nice when you can tell you're just pushing the thing instead of smashing into it. Come on, points. Where are you? Group. Oh, no, that was a chip right there. They sound very similar. These palm roots. It was sandy sound. It does sometimes. Oh. Okay, that's something right there, it looks like. Oh, God, look. Oh, I get too excited. Hold your horses. It looks like it's just going to be a big chip. It is a big chip. Ah, but that's what happens. You see something and it looks like something else and you start tripping out. Nice color, wow. That's the root. So yeah, this is fun. This is probably, I do a lot of things I enjoy, gardening, but it's up there with artifact hunting. I'll always have a garden and I'll always teach people how to grow food, but this is my supreme passion of all time, is archaeology, and it always has been. And I've always dug since I first was introduced to it by Tom Clark and also Dean Quigley. And hi to both of you guys out there. So they kind of took me to all these sites, and I remember my first time riding out to places in the back of the pickup truck, because a newbie always had to ride in the back of the pickup truck. this is 30 years later and it doesn't die down. If anything, the more you learn how to do it the right way, the more fun it is, because you're not breaking stuff and there's more of a respect for for the site. I don't know. Instead of just, in my younger days, I probably plowed through a lot of stuff that I missed. And I don't want to do that anymore. So some of the videos I'll be doing on this channel are going to be going to very inaccessible places, whether in Florida or, and it's going to be all over the country. I've got some plans for something on the 24th where I'm going to go to a very interesting place that not a lot of people around here know how to get to. And I'm not going to say where it is. I'll probably not give out the name of it, but this is a giant Indian mound that's about 25 feet tall at the top. And if you were to walk from one end of the platform on the top to the other, it's 250 feet. So that is a huge, huge mound. And it's got ramps going up to it. It's got some cuts from Clarence B. Moore when he went through there, and some archaeological holes you can see. But that's really exciting. I'll be doing that on the 24th. So if you like this kind of thing, as they always say, you got to subscribe and hit the little bell thing. I think people say that too much, so I'm not going to be doing all that. People can like and do the bell if they want to, because that's how I feel about it. There's too many likes and subscribes and bells and stuff in people's videos, in my opinion. And it's not knocking anybody. That's just, I know that's the way it's done, but I'm not going to be doing it the same way as other people. Maybe. I say that now. But hopefully that'll remain. Okay, let's get back to this. I'll do it a couple more minutes while I wait for Brian to get here, and I'm gonna do an interview with him about archaic people. Now these are a little higher up here, obviously, so we'll see if anything pops out. If there's a first stage point anywhere in here, they are pretty big. You know, it can be 5 inches, 4 inches, 6 inches. I mean, they can be 8. I mean, they can be crazy, crazy huge if we're lucky. Brian coming here had some of the biggest points I've ever seen. He had, hang on, helicopter going overhead. Well, he's just got some really big points. One big blue, and I think the other one is big red. I mean, I think they're red point and blue point. I'll ask him about those when he gets back. All right, so back to this. And you know, this is the way it is. See that charcoal right there? That's very good signs when you're in charcoal and chips and bone. And there's shell also in here. Okay, let's see what's in there. Taking some big layers off here and see what happens. Sometimes you can just knock a big block down and the points will just fall out. Okay, I'll knock these blocks down. If anything comes out, we'll be lucky. If not, we're still lucky. But I'll shut it down after that and then start it when Brian gets here. And as I get hopefully more subscribers and am able to fuel more trips and stuff, then that will allow me to go further and further afield. And so I'm going to go to some places like the Everglades and canoe trips out there, possibly for a few days. It would take a few days for what I'm looking for out there. So it's there is still adventure in the world, and sometimes it seems like there isn't, but there's a lot of mystery out there, and it still exists. And that's it. I'll see you next time.